Hello. So from today and this video, we'll be creating a new game. It is a platformer game like Mario, in which the sprite moves in the front or backward direction, and the sprite has the obstacles in between in its way, which the sprite has to overcome to gain coins and points to reach the next level. So let us begin with this. First of all, we'll create a new project, and after creating the new project, we know how the interface looks like. And first of all, what we'll do, we'll delete this old sprite. Then we'll choose another sprite, and we want a sprite that works, because like Mario, in Mario game, the sprite walks in the right and left direction or jumps to gain points. So we need a sprite that can walk. So I'll type here walking, and we can choose any sprite from these. So I'll be choosing every this sprite, and you can choose any of the sprites that were there in the walking section. And I'll reduce the size of this every to 50 because it was too big. Now it's fine. Yeah, 50 was good. Or maybe 45. Yeah, 45 looks fine. Perfect. So now what I want that when the right arrow key is pressed, then the sprite every moves in the right direction. And when the left arrow key is pressed, then the sprite moves in the left direction. It is very simple. We will now come in the code section, and we will give the sprite some codes and instructions to move in the right or the left direction respectively. So first of all, what I'll do, I'll choose when the green flag is clicked. What I want that if right key is pressed, then the sprite moves in the right direction. So first of all, I'll use forever block because I want it to repeat forever, and then I'll use if then loop because I want if the right key is pressed, then the sprite moves in the right direction. So I'll choose if keys is pressed, and I'll change space to right arrow key. If right arrow key is pressed, then I want that the sprite should move forward in the right direction. So what I'll do, I'll use point in direction 90 degree. Why I'm choosing point in direction 90 degree? I'm choosing this because I don't want the sprite to move in the backward direction right now or in the opposite direction right now. I want that the sprite should move in the right direction or in the forward direction. So that is why I'm using point in direction of 90 degree and move 10 steps because I want the sprite to move 10 steps. And let us play and see if it's moving or not. Now I can see that the sprite is moving. Now what else I want? I want that if the left arrow key is pressed, then the sprite should move in the left direction. So what I'll do, I'll again choose if then block, I'll include it in the forever block, and I'll again choose if key left arrow is pressed. I'll change it to left arrow key because I want that the frog should move, that the sprite should move in the left direction. And now what I'll do, I will choose move 10 steps because I want the sprite to move 10 steps, and I will set the rotation style to left and right, to left to right, because I want the sprite to move from left to right. That is why, and I want the sprite to move in the backward direction. That is why I'll be using point in direction 90 degree. I'll change 90 degree to minus 90 degree. Because like this way, I can see that the arrow is now left hand side or the backward side. Now the Sprite will move in this direction where this arrow is pointed. So this is it. So now let us see if it's working or not by clicking on the green flag button. So now I can see that this is working in both the directions, like right and left, right and left. But what I can also see is that the legs of the sprite are not moving. They are still, but the sprite is moving. So in the next video, what we'll do, we'll add the movement in the legs of the sprite. Till then, keep practicing these videos and gain command over the coding section of Scratch. Thank you. Meet you in the next video.